This is the new Tesla Model Y Standard. The new one, the cheap one, the entry level, the one that's available for less than 40,000 euros. And in this video, I'm gonna see, is it still a Tesla though? So what do I mean when I say, is it still a Tesla? Because obviously this car is made by Tesla. However, a Tesla as an EV needs to have a few specifics that makes it special. For example, it needs to have excellent software. It needs to have ease of traveling. It needs to be very efficient. It also needs to be minimalist, yet advanced on the inside. And I wonder, is this car still a Tesla by that definition? So today I'm gonna test the car. So the outside still looks very much like a Tesla Model Y with a few exceptions. We got these 18-inch wheels with a full cover on them. And if you see the wheel behind it, you'll know why they've covered it up. We've also got no light bar here in the front. We've got the regular two front headlights, but there's no light bar connecting them. I actually like this look quite a lot. You see, there's no light bar. Usually there's a light connecting the two rear lights here that sort of projects an afterburner down on the floor. But nope, you don't get that in this one. You also have a slightly different roofline with a curvy glass. In fact, it is quite interesting and funny to see that there is actually a glass roof off here on top, but on the inside, it's just a regular roof. It's not a massive difference. It's just slight little details here. We still got all the cameras and everything for the autopilot stuff. So yeah, in essence, that bit is still a Tesla, right? If you open it up, it also looks very basic. There's some space in here for your stuff, but everything is just like, you can see all the innards of the car. And this bit here doesn't have that rubber thing for insulation that really makes sure that any vibration created out here in this space doesn't carry on inside. Now listen to this. In the back, there's a decent space. We've even got additional space here down below the floor for more stuff, and there's also stuff in here if we want to put our charging cables and everything. It's all right, the space is generous enough. However, there's no cover, so anything you've got in here will just, you know, fall inside the car in case there's an accident. I guess you can buy something on Amazon to cover it up. You might ask yourself, how come Tesla put such an ugly cover on their car? And I'll show you why. Look. If you remove the cover, which you can do quite easily, you get this. Nasty. Okay, so let me show you. I am here and I'm gonna go to this place here, and it's gonna be a trip of, look, this is Madrid, that's Barcelona over here, and it's gonna be a trip of a total of 440 kilometers as it says up there. Right now, it's 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And according to this system, I'm going to do one stop at a Tesla supercharger of a total of 11 minutes. Right, but that's the theory. Now let's actually do it. 15 degrees Celsius outside. Probably a little bit colder once I get moving. It is at the end of December after all. It'll probably be chill on the way. But let's get moving. Enough chit chat. Right, so I've been driving for about an hour and 20 minutes. I've done 140 kilometers so far. There was a bit of traffic getting out of the city, but now we're in the open roads and I can do 120 just all the time. I'm using the autopilot system because this being the standard version, in Europe, it does come with the autopilot. If you're in the US watching it from there, it does not come with autopilot. I believe you only have cruise control. I'm not even sure it's adaptive, just regular good old fashioned cruise control. But here we've got autopilot as default included with the car. You can also add the enhanced autopilot or the FSD, the full self-driving, which in this case is activated on the car. However, as I am in Europe, even though I've got full self-driving activated, the only thing that it actually does is change lanes automatically when I put the blinkers on. It's as good as any other Tesla in that respect. We are arriving at the supercharger location here. This is a nice big supercharger, loads of posts. Okay, so we've done 278.7 kilometers. Efficiency is 154 watt hours per kilometer. That will be the same as 250 watt hours per mile. We still have 27% of the battery left, so we just spent 83%, which means the full range of this car is 390 kilometers. Same as 240 miles. Okay, I've been here 10 minutes. I couldn't go to the loo any faster. And it says that I've charged sufficiently to continue my trip, and I've actually got 64% of battery now. So I'm gonna unplug and let's get going. All right, so we're on our way again, and we've got another 1 hour and 40 minutes. And I should get to my destination with 18% of battery left. So that's more than initially estimated, maybe because I took like 11 minutes instead of 8 minutes. Okay, I'm at the hotel right now. I just arrived at the supercharger. You can see it right there. And I've done a total of, 440 kilometers and efficiency of 160 watt hours per kilometer. That is very good. As you can see, it's now 11 degrees. So temperature hasn't changed too much. I've done all of this at 120 kilometers now. I just, you know, set the autopilot to 120 and let it do the speed and the steering most of the way. Do you know what? One thing I do notice while driving at night is that the headlights are not matrix headlights. See, when I'm driving, I can either have the normal headlights on or the, you know, let me just blind some people there, or the full ones on. If you have the one that isn't the standard, you got matrix headlights that will turn on and off pixels according to where you have oncoming traffic. And that's a big difference when you're driving a lot at night. I am now currently charging at, I'm not sure if it's focusing right, but 185 kilowatts and charging to 100% from 30, well, actually this was 25 a minute ago, is only gonna take me half an hour. So this car will charge all of this in just half an hour. Whereas, for example, in my long range dual motor, from 80 to 100% is 20 minutes. It seems like this one has a better charging curve, and maybe they've improved slightly on the top speed. Right, job done. I've had my meetings here in Lerida, and now I'm going back to Madrid. Today, it's a bit warmer, sun. Yeah, I know, it's December, but I am in Spain. Let's see if efficiency improves as weather and temperature improves as well. Let's try to charge this thing in optimal condition. So I'm at a Tesla supercharger, as you can see here. And I've got only 7% of battery right now, as you can see here. I've driven, I've preheated the battery and everything. We're using 16 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometers when we're driving on highways. So now what we need to do is charge 200 kilometers and see how long time that'll take us. We are charging now at 112, 114. Come on, this number needs to go up, 122. And we should be able to get all the way up to 180-ish. So we are now at, oh, can't see it there. Where's the screen? There you go. Oh, wow. 13 minutes, 33 kilowatt hours charge. But there's a difference between what it says here and what it says in the car. So we've been here now 13 minutes, and we're still charging at 122. Inside the Tesla Model Y standard, there are quite a few differences with the other versions. For example, we've got manually adjusted steering wheel here. We have electronically adjusted seats. However, you can do this from the screen, but even better, you can actually use the steering wheel controls to adjust your seat. So you have to sort of select which part of the seat you want to adjust, and then by using the controls on the steering wheel, you can adjust it to your own preferences. Of course, you have profiles, so as soon as you've adjusted it, you can save it. Next time you step into the car, it'll recognize your mobile phone and adjust everything to your settings. So that's quite good. For the co-pilot, you can only adjust two things. You can move the seat back and forth, and you can incline or decline the rear part of the seat. That's it, no further adjustments there. So the seats are now made out of cloth and faux leather. So the leather is sort of in the sides, but you sit on the cloth and you have cloth on the back, which helps with overheating. And now there is no glass roof in this car either. So I guess it should be a little bit better or more comfortable to use in these warm weather climates as here in Spain, where I am, where, well, today it's rainy, but usually it doesn't. Although, other than that, the materials are quite good. I know that there's no more wood or anything else like that on the doors. However, they still look pretty good. Materials are soft, it's well stitched together. There's no piano black plastic that leaves fingerprints everywhere. It's all pretty good, you know? It doesn't feel cheap. It might feel a little bit more simple in here, or a little bit less cluttered. However, it doesn't feel cheap at all. In the center console, I've got plenty of space down here and a USB-C port. I've also got two cup holders, a massive space here in the middle, because there's no more big middle console here. And then I've got two phone chargers. Now, you might have seen that these phone chargers are quite upright, and I thought that the phone was going to fly out under hard acceleration. Fortunately, this car doesn't do hard acceleration. So no problem, they stay in place. Overall, the feeling is that they've simplified it. They cut away things like, you know, the LED light strips, and maybe it looks a bit more, or a bit less sophisticated, but you're not really missing much in here other than that, and the materials are still very, very good. Software-wise, this is exactly the same software as you get in any other Tesla. You get this, you know, you can colorize your Tesla, you get all the games, you get the navigation through superchargers, you get all of the excellent Tesla software in there. You get the online streaming and everything. And that is a hallmark of Teslas for me. That is one of the things that really make a Tesla a Tesla. It's the software. And I'm amazed at how poorly some software is in some other cars. They just don't understand the importance of this. Now, if you own a Tesla, you definitely know how important the software is for the car. In the US, you don't get autopilot. In Europe, you do. So you don't have to pay anything. It's just standard autopilot that'll keep you in your lane and accelerate or brake for traffic. You don't get lane changes and you don't get full self-driving. That is an extra cost. But it does have the ability to add all of that. You just have to pay for it. It's got the full software, it's got the computer, and it's got all of that pre-installed. So I'd say that they've taken away quite a few things on this car, but none that I really, really miss, except for one, and that would be the matrix headlights. So this car's just got normal high beams, but in other Teslas, you get matrix headlights, so that sort of will turn on and off individual pixels not to blind oncoming traffic while still keeping the high beams on. However, in this one, it's either high beams or low beams. It'll automatically switch between the two, but I do miss the matrix headlights. The rest, yeah. I could do with a glass roof. It does make it feel a little bit more space if you're sitting in the back, but I'm okay with them having removed it. Funny enough, this glass on the outside, however, this glass is not heat treated, so it won't keep the sun out, and that's why they've put the cloth up there. So here in the back, I do feel that they've cut some corners, and I can tell that this is not the premium version. I miss the glass roof. Sitting in the front, I don't mind so much because you're mainly looking out the front, but sitting in the back, yeah, this feels a lot less airy and a lot less open, absolutely. The seats are also a lot less comfortable. The cloth seats again, and it's also quite flat. So there's not a big difference between the sides and the middle seat in here. I have no screen here in the back. I don't really mind that all that much. It might have been nice to have one, but I can live without it. Do have two USB-C ports, but overall this isn't great. Now if I fall down here because I want to have an armrest, then I can't really use it. The armrest is too low. It's not for putting your arm there. It is for two cup holders. However, if you use these cup holders, there's an opening to the back, and if you have something in the back, it's just gonna fly out if you have an accident. So I do not recommend that. One thing I do appreciate here in the back is that we've got tinted glass both on the sides and in the back just to keep the sun out and just to give us a little bit extra privacy. The car is now charged at 100%. I think it's time we test the acceleration. This is the slowest Tesla Model Y ever, so let's do an acceleration test. This is the draggy. Okay, so I'm literally at 99% battery. I guess the roads are dry by now. So let's see. 0 to 100 in. Well, it's not very dramatic, is it? After several test runs, 0 to 100 in the Tesla Model Y standard is 7.2 seconds. I guess 7.2 is not bad at all. It's just for Tesla, we're used to like 2 point something or 3 point something. Tesla's got this very clever automatic gear selector. So when I get into the car and I'll put on my seatbelt, and now if I put my foot on the brake, it'll automatically select a gear for me, in this case, reverse, because it correctly has identified that there's a tree right in front of me. So I will then, let's see, I better go that way. I'll back out. And then when I put my foot on the brake again and turn, it'll automatically select the gear for going forward. And this works really, really well. And in a ton of different situations, it'll just automatically select the right gear for you. It's a clever system. And even though I can manually switch gears on the screen or even up here if I have, for some reason, no screen, then, you know, many times I just don't need to do it. Oh, and I got blinkers, an actual blinker stalk. I know if you're used to driving a BMW, you don't care, but you know, there are some Teslas without blinker stalks on them. I do appreciate this one. It's also very good at parking itself. So it'll do it between cars, and it'll do it also just by finding the white lines. So let's just pick one, right? You can see all these parking spaces it's found around me there. I'll pick one that's like way behind me to the left. And this works if you're parallel parking, or even if you're parking, you know, next to other cars. It's quite fast and works really well. Now, if I put my foot on the brake, will it select the gears that go forward? Yes, indeed. So in theory, this car is less acoustically insulated than the premium version of the car. For example, the window is just a single glass, where the others are double laminate glass. There's also, you know, less isolation in the frunk. Materials are overall a bit cheaper. I can't really tell though. I mean, it's not very noisy in here. It's still a well-built car. Maybe if I drove the two back to back, there might be a difference. But right now, I can't say that this is a noisy car or that I'm feeling like, oh, they should definitely make this quieter. Even at highway speeds, at, you know, traveling quite fast, there's no wind noise or no particular wind noise. Maybe there's a little bit of road noise, but nothing that I can like specifically put my finger on and say, ooh, this is where they've saved some dollars. So is it still a Tesla? Well, absolutely. It's easy to travel with it. It's still technologically advanced. It still integrates the chargers, the application. It's got a brilliant system on the inside. It's minimalist and it's still high tech. Yeah, they've cut a few corners here and there. And yeah, it's a bit more simple in some places. But in essence, this is still a Tesla. And to me, this is the best value for money you can currently get. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have, leave a comment down below. Subscribe, like, and all that other YouTube stuff. I'll see you again shortly with another video review. We've got a very interesting thing coming up. Catch you later.